Hello and welcome to St. Mary's Now, a partnership between the Enterprise newspaper and the Forest Center TV video production program. I'm Jordan Imsbacher.
And I'm Jessica Eumann, and here's the latest news from the Enterprise. Kids involved with the Future Leaders of the World, or FLOW, started building a garden at Lexington Park Elementary School this week. Fourth and fifth graders helped build star-shaped garden beds that sit outside next to the playground. Jonathan Bush, a fourth grader at the school, said, "It's really fun because we get to build, and when we get older, we can do other stuff." Florence Klein, a mentor helping with the project, assembling the gardens made her want to start her own. "It has me inspired. FLOW's mission is to match students with caring adults in the community to help with the child's academic and social skills."
Hunting may no longer be restricted in St. Mary's on Sundays if a bill proposed by Senator Jack Bailey passes through the House. Senate Bill 390, which would allow any person in the county to hunt any game bird or game mammal on Sundays during open season on those animals, passed out of the Senate last month and was heard in the House Environment and Transportation Committee Wednesday afternoon. While St. Mary's hunters may look forward to the expanded hunting, many are also concerned about a pair of bills seeking to regulate private sales of long guns. House Bill 786 and Senate Bill 737 would require a long gun owner and a potential buyer to meet with a licensed firearm dealer before the gun may be transferred. The dealer would be required to conduct a background check at the cost of the buyer. Delegate Brian Crosby said in an interview, "The entire intent behind this is to ensure people with violent criminal history do not get their hands on firearms on a secondary market transaction." Last June, five Capital Gazette newspaper staff members were killed with a rifle in Annapolis. Last month, Rachel Pacella testified before the Senate committee in the support of the bill. "Anything that will prevent one shooting of any size would be worth your vote, and this bill will do that," said Mark Pennick, president of the Maryland Child Issue.
The entrances to local schools are about to become more secure. The St. Mary's Board of Education recently approved the installation of external door monitoring systems in order to prevent intrusions. The Department of St. Mary's Public Schools Safety and Security has already made updates to schools throughout the county, including vestibules, ballistic window film, door alarms, and more cameras. Superintendent Scott Smith explained that the door alarm system will be placed at the security station in the vestibule to the main office, so the security assistant can see who's coming in and out of all ground level exterior doors through a monitor. The first installation will be at Choptank High School during spring break in April, Great Mills in May, and Leonardtown over the summer.
On Wednesday evening, parents and children attended the open house for the county's STEM Academy at Spring Ridge Middle School. The program is available to students from grades between 4th through 12th, and applications for next year are accepted until April 19th. Denise Mandis, the school system supervisor of instruction, addressed a group of parents in the gym at Spring Ridge to break down what their children should expect when they begin middle school academy. The elementary academy is housed at Lexington Park Elementary, while the high school academy is at Great Mills High School.
St. Mary's Riken boys lacrosse team made a trip to Washington, D.C. on Tuesday to play St. John's in its first Washington Catholic Athletic Conference matchup of the year. The Knights came back home having suffered their first loss of the campaign after the Cadets won 12-6, keyed by a six-goal third quarter. Pete Burns, a senior at Riken, said it's always a great experience getting to play every team in this conference, but especially when we get to come out and play against one of our rivals like St. John's. It just brings another feel to the game. We all just get pumped and ready to go out there. This news brief has been provided by the Enterprise. For more details, visit somdnews.com. That's all we have for you in this edition of St. Mary's Now. I'm Jessica Eumann.
And I'm Jordan Imsbacher, signing off.